So just these two will be these two or these two?
It'll be these two. Ring finger and the middle.
Okay. That one in the picture is matte.
I know.
Like gloss.
You like gloss? No, this just has to be matte, man.
You think so?
Okay. Yes, it's fall. Falls up all matted. Very thin coats. Don't want to lose my shape, okay, y'all? I didn't spend all that time shaping for nothing. You have a smooth surface, you have the polish very smooth also. Two thin coats. What I need, what I'm looking for, ideally. Sleeps on polishing techniques, man. Nowadays we're so spoiled with color powder, nobody thinks they need to polish anymore. That's why it's so hard for people to do art. Nope, you don't have to put a clear over it because this acrylic is not it's not a natural nail bed. It won't have oils. You gotta put it, you're talking about a base coat. So gel polish will bond on top of acrylics like this easily. As long as you paint thin. A lot of times you guys paint too thick. What happens then is that it won't cure properly. That's why it peels. Pretty thin coats, two coats. Make sure your machine is a proper machine that cures the product you're using. A lot of times you have a UV only or LED only machine and the product is UV LED. So it won't cure properly. And that's why you have issues with peeling and bubbling and wrinkling and all the above. Cuticle there. When you do good cuticle work, the polish won't kind of, it won't drip up to the cuticle area because there's a nice slope effect there. You still keep that shape. I absolutely hate it when I see nail techs do such great shape and then what happens? They do thick polishing and they lose their shape. Second coat. It's gonna bring out the color, the texture. Look at that nice hunter green. When this comes matte, it's gonna look so nice. Yeah. And you're welcome. If I can catch your questions, I would definitely. You don't cap the ends of the gel polish? Nope. I don't. Because it makes it thicker. And then I'll lose my shape. Most of the time, clients don't care about capped ends because I'm using a nice nude. This is not like a black or a pink or something like that. It's a nice nude, so you really don't mind it at the tip there. I remember the last time any client's like, oh my gosh, I can see the tips. I'm like, Once you cap the ends, you gotta top coat the ends, you gotta do all the other things to the ends, and those ends are not like the surface here. You'll lose the shape. That's my personal preference. Hey, if you have to cap the ends and you wanna do it, go for it. But I am not gonna get that crisp shape if I'm gonna cap the ends. That's just me saying, period. And And if you have issues with lifting or chipping at the tips, it's not really because of the capped ends. It's the how you paint curing process.
Placing my hands slowly. I'm infamous for messing up my nail paint. Placing my hands in slowly.
So you're infamous for messing up? I know you are. Like, at least you admit it.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I like that pink. That's nice.
It's a nude.
It's a nude.
Okay, now for some line work. I definitely would not prefer not to use these gel polishes, but since it's just minimal, I'll be able to deal with it. Oh, sorry. Generally, I would like to use a gel art paint so it's nice and pigmented, but since I don't have that ability because I don't have the color for it, I'm not going to use this gel polish because I want to keep the color combination nice and even. I have to deal with it, okay? I'm gonna put flowers on this later. She made me do a lot of work today. We're gonna go back through this with another green. Just get that nice pigment out there. Make sure it's nice and deep. Nice. Not bad for a gel polish. See, I have to cure in between because I'm using a gel polish, so I know it's not going to be as thin as in a pigmented. So I have to cure in between because I don't want to have it. I don't want to do the whole design and the whole hand and then have it come back to it and it's going to like move. It's probably one of the biggest issues with sometimes using gel polish here. But sometimes we got to do what we got to do because I don't have the gel art paint to match these colors. I definitely don't have the time to sit there and mix them. This is why we charge more for artwork, guys. It takes time. This is, you can't rush. That's why we gotta make sure we are set done sooner so we have more time to do this. Last one. Go back through this with a little bit more pigment. Move on to my next color, which is burnt orange here. Jeez, she just fell and hurt herself. Okay.
they see?
Yeah, they can see. All these colors are gonna come so vibrant once you mat it, guys. Matting is the most important thing here. Torn because I don't have the gel art paint for this, but it is what it is. I'm gonna make do with what I got. Hear that first part, I did this, it's gonna melt in. Mistake. Let's finish up here before I put my flowers. I'm gonna hit it with a mat and I'm gonna add my watercolor flowers. Let's mat it. You thought it? Thought it? Lamb and acetone. I need my acetone. I have to my acetone. Acetone. Like about an acetone, you remember? Oops, 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 oops. I forgot this. I forgot the outline, the final touches. Yikes! Sorry, guys. Come on. There's some finishing touches. One more time. Where's my what? Black.
Black or white?
My white? No! This one a little more darker here. It's too light here. I've got to outline it. Once you this is called color blocking. Once you color block, you outline, or you add detail work into it. I'll show you guys exactly how that works right in the second here. It brings everything out. What? See that? Switch. Switch, not gonna matter everything. Well, that green with the matte, so nice. Look at that. You need the stones to tie this in, though.
Huh?
You need some stones to tie this in.
You sure?
Yeah. I mean, if they fall off, they fall off, but like the way the design is on the picture is you need the stones. Or it's gonna be little gaps missing. It's not gonna be the flowers. So I'm gonna do what you call ink marbling, watercolor flowers. Since I don't have the stickers in the picture. I wish I had the same color jar paint for the line work. Just completely different. A little bit more struggle. This nice thin coat of matte. Okay. Go ahead and switch. Finishing touches. Those guys are still here. We're gonna end strong. Put a little bit of brown ink into acetone. I'm gonna use a little detailer brush to give myself the little petals. Yes, sir. little petals, and I'll draw the stems in later to tie it in. You guys have probably seen these stickers around, right? That's cute. Trust the process, guys. Trust the process, right? Clients will send you pictures like this and be like, can I get that done for $40? Yes? Yes, you can. Just come here, I'll print out the picture for you. Oh, that's cute. Oh, yeah, see, I did it.
Yay.
I did it. Bro, I literally, in the picture, it's stickers, and I have to really do it by hand. Come on. Some props for that. That's why you gotta, as a nail tech, you gotta really make things work, you know? Sometimes it's... You thought I couldn't do it with this. You thought I couldn't do it, huh?
I didn't think it was gonna look like that.
Child.
It's really cute.
When I set my mind to it, I'd do it. What's up? Why you calling me?
How are you, sir? Except the employees.
The what?
Think I look? No, no,
go. Go ahead. Bring them in. Okay. Someone just called the shop?
No, she's right there.
Oh, she's here? I'm always need tech if they know that if they can do stuff that I need them to do. Yes, you know what this is right here? This is literally acetone and a little bit of like a brown ink. Hello, hello, Jay.
They been
saying. Oh, thank you, Jay. Chị làm gì chân tay nước chứ đếp hả? Không biết làm bột hả? Ok. Làm xanh được không? Em nhờ em mướn thợ, em mướn phải cần làm xanh đây. Xanh đây. Yes.
Nếu mình chỉ làm cứ 5, 6, 7 chủ nhật nha.
Thứ 5, 6, 7 chủ nhật còn mấy ngày kia sao?
Tại vì chị làm được
part-time. Oh, em cần full-time chị ơi. On full-time only right now. It's busy season, chị. I can't. Làm full time được 5 ngày em được hả? No 5 day?
5, 6, 7, 4
ngày rồi. I need 5 day, I'm sorry. I need 5 day. Because everybody here works 5 day at least, it's only fair. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Tại sao đây? I cũng everybody here works 5 days, so I can't, you know.
Ở đây mình nhận bỏ mấy ngày hết
hả? 7 day. 8 day a week sometimes. We busy, so 8 day a week. Gonna make money. Chase the bag. So let me know. If you're gonna work 5 day, I'll take you. Okay? Lên con ấy nó sẽ nó lấy được con
cho chị hỏi em chạy thông tin được không? Chị mà mình làm đây là mình chia 4-6
6-4
ừ. Vậy chắc cũng
7-3
nhưng mà cho chị hỏi cái tiền mình làm income đây là cũng
chị ở đây chị mà có tay nghề chị sẽ làm có income à, em không có làm bao lương gì hết đó. Làm thì làm thôi. Ở đây không ai bắt luôn hết á. Nó có khả năng, em có khách là nó sẽ làm à. Thì em cũng nó nếu mà ai có tài nghề là sẽ làm được. So I have to add stones to this guys because
yeah, you're right, it's missing.
It's just missing the stones, man.
Xin lỗi em tên gì hả?
John John. Em tên John.
John.
Ừ, cái gì đem
tao. Okay, để chị suy nghĩ là chị coi chị làm được năm.
Okay chị. Yeah.
Rồi nhưng mà chị làm biết được nhưng mà chị làm móng dài á thì chị làm hơi xấu.
Chị vô chị làm á, em trong vòng 1 tuổi 2 tuổi em sẽ biết tay nghề chị ở đâu rồi chị, em sẽ cho chị biết chị làm được gì được gì.
Chị
biết móng
dài chị làm hơi xấu, móng ngắn thì ok.
Where are my gold stones? Hold on guys.
Nếu mà bắt đầu làm thì qua tuần em
cho. Mm-hmm. Yes. Yes chị. I need to get some gold stones.
Yeah, the stone we're gonna
get out.
Hold on. Oh, beautiful nail.
Thank you.
I need some gold, some like champagne stones in here. I'm gonna use my gem, glue gem. This one right here, my gold too. Gotta be careful because I already have my mat top going on. So I just want to put enough stones here so that would just stick, okay?
Oh yeah, he needed it.
He needed it bad. I'm gonna swap the stones this way. I like it better this way. I don't like how they position in the picture for some reason. Yeah, this is way better. It's not my taste the way they have it in the picture. These stones real quick. God, it has to be perfect. I gotta put some more matte taco on there because this is gonna make it shiny. We're intentionally, in the beginning we weren't gonna do stones, but now we're doing stones, so we gotta make sure it's right. I'm trying to land two little stones up in here in this cuticle area here. Thing I like about this gem glue that I have is that it doesn't seal in until I want it to seal in. So I have plenty of time to work with it.
I don't think I've ever tried your gem glue yet.
You? Why would you try it?
Well, no, I haven't put it on my nails.
No, I haven't. I've done it. What? Oh, God damn it. Did I hit this in my hand and not notice? They all saw it too on the live. They're like, oh my God, he just messed that shit up. The thing I do don't like about this is it gets a little bit sticky. I should have cured this before I did the other hand. Oh man, I did hit it with my hand.
Oh yeah.
I wanna cry. Didn't even notice it. So there, I gotta put some matte on that area there because this is no longer be matte. It's okay. See how I didn't seal it in yet, so I'm still good. These little beads are so pretty, but they're so freaking, I hate using them. Just so annoying to secure on. Okay, go ahead.
Oh yeah, It needed it so bad, I didn't even notice.
Of course it did.
I was doing myself a disadvantage by saying that.
I don't know why. strange. That one just has that one. This one has two down the middle. And we can crown this one. Even though they don't have it in the picture, I want to do it like this. Oh, that's so goddamn cute, y'all. And look, I wouldn't have messed this up like I thought I would. Okay, we're done. Just gonna touch up some mat in some areas to make sure it's nice and matted again. And I'm just gonna be very careful with this mat here. I'm just gonna go around. Well, actually, I have to mat it anyways because I have to protect the ink from getting messed up. I'm gonna try not to get it onto the stones. Just seal the mat in on the side of the stones. So I don't want. Remember, I did the ink flowers. These flowers are so cute, y'all. Look at this. Like, it's a sticker that I saw, but look at them now. I don't know who's still here, but damn it.
Put some mat on the corner. Green
thumb. Oh, okay. Look how cute these little flowers are.
And you can, very cute.
And you wouldn't even need stickers.
I know.
I'm gonna do that again. And another client. Alright, go ahead. Look at these little tiny little flowers. Like, just simply putting a little bit of ink marbling and some acetone together, making a little bit of water color solution, and look at it go. Ideally, if I had all the products I did, the gel products, I definitely would have done better. But we work with what we got.